What is up everyone, Adam here from Hooked Fishing. Hope you're having a great day. In this video, I will be going over all the tackle that I own. This is going to be a tackle tour video. Now, before I even get into this video, I want to propose an idea to you guys. This video can break 50 likes, then I'll be giving away some of my tackle. I'm not going to say exactly which tackle yet until the end of the video, but 50 likes, I'll be giving some away. If you want to be entered to win it, like the video, make sure you subscribe to our channel, and then comment something down below, whether it's your favorite bait that I own, your favorite bait, future video idea, whatever you want to comment down below, just comment down below. You have a chance to win. I'll give this video 1 week to reach 50 likes. Now let's get right into it. Alright, now if you follow our channel, you know that we throw a lot of jigs and Texas rigs with craw imitations and all that stuff because we have a lot of good cover to flip and pitch in all of our lakes around here. So I think it's only fit to start with all the soft plastics I have that are either creature baits or craws. Before I dive right into all the craws and creature baits, I need to organize this giant pile of soft plastics into what each one of them actually is. So get a little time lapse of this real quick and I'll be right back with you. Alright, now we go to a little, let's say like, I don't know, half oval formed of all the baits organized by swim baits, fluke style baits, creature baits, and just other miscellaneous things. I don't know what the heck I'd consider them. Craw imitations, more finesse worms, Sankos, and then our big worms. So we got it all laid out, and now let's get right into it, starting with the craws and the creature baits. So in front of me I got all of my craw baits laid out that I have, soft plastic wise, and we'll get started with the smallest of all of them, which is the Cabin Creek 2.75 inch Junior Express Craw. This thing has some sweet colors in it, got it in a Lucky Tackle box. Really good finesse craw if you're looking to throw on a little shaky head or a little tiny jig, anything like that. It's a smaller presentation, good for this cold water right now. And now the Vicious Tubby Tube, or Tubby Tube, however you want to pronounce that. And this is a tube style bait, obviously, by the name. I don't throw a lot of tubes. Vinny's thrown tubes before. He said they're really good, and I've heard from many people that they're very good. So I might have to give these a try this year for some smallmouth or something. And then we got the Hoax Fish 4-inch Bamboozy Craw and Green Pumpkin. Another thing from LTB. Really like it. Has some really long, but nothing that's going to make any crazy action in the water. So it's more of like a subtle presentation. Probably be good to flip in the cover. It won't get stuck with all the appendages. Next is the Buddha Base 4-inch Baby Mama. Now I caught some nice fish on this in a fall pond bassing video. I don't know why I can't say that. In 2016, it was actually our last like bass fishing video of 2016. I caught some nice ones flipping this thing around. It's a pretty nice bait. It's got some nice ridges in it. It's got some pretty nice action in the water too. It's 4 inches, so it's a little bit bigger. So bigger fish, bigger bait. And then the Yum Christy Craw, which just has a lot of appendages hanging off of it, so it has a lot of action in the water, puts out a lot of vibration. Pretty good for if you're not throwing around a lot of cover and you want to give off a lot of vibration in the water, this would be a good one to go with. Now the Net Bait Baby Packer Craw. This is another pretty good bait from Lucky Tackle Box. I really like it. And now, probably either my favorite or my second to favorite bait for craw style baits, which is the Rage Bug. Now, we got these when we first started working with Lucky Tackle Box like 2 years ago, and they absolutely slammed the smallmouth up at the North Pier in Lake Erie and Presque Isle. And ever since then, I've been a big fan of them. I got them in Black Neon, Watermelon Red Flake, and Green Pumpkin. Those are the three packs I have left, and they just absolutely have an amazing action to them. They're an amazing punching bait, flipping bait. Anything you can think of, you can do with these Rage Bugs. Absolutely love them. And now next, we'll get into what we actually got in the Lucky Tackle Box for January, and that is the Rage Craw. I got this one, and then I have a pack that came out of the package, but these baits also have the Rage Tail technology, which gives off the amazing vibration and action in the water. So I'm assuming these will be just as good as the Rage Bug, a little bit of a thinner body style than the Rage Bug. The Rage Bug's pretty fat. These are nice and thin, more like a craw imitation than the Rage Bug. But again, Strike King Rage Tail, can't complain. Probably gonna be a great bait. And then this is my other favorite craw imitation. It's the Havoc Pit Boss, and I have these in green pumpkin green, green pumpkin green and purple, watermelon orange fleck, fleck, I don't know why, black and blue. So I have them in a lot of colors. I have four packs of these, and they're all 4 inches except for one that's 3 inches for a little bit smaller presentations. But that's all my craw style baits. Now let's get into the creature style baits. All right, and now we'll get into what I consider my creature baits. Some of these could go either way, imitating a craw, creature bait. I just consider these less like craws. I mean, they still might imitate a craw, but they don't look as much like a craw as what I just went over. So let's get right into these. We'll start out with the Gary Yamamoto 4-inch DTH Grub. Now, this would be like a good, I'd say like a good swim jig trailer, like a little bit of a smaller trailer, because I've got the two tails that'll paddle in the water like this. That's more for like a swim jig or maybe like a small chatterbait trail or something like that. Now, the Zoom 6-inch lizard. It's in watermelon, I believe. Yeah, watermelon red. These lizards, we tried them down in Florida. Surprisingly, we didn't catch anything because Florida's known for a lot of lizard fishing, at least according to the people we know down there. But these baits look sweet in the water. I bet they'll do good in PA this year, too. And the good old Zoom brush hog. You have to have one of these. These things are absolutely amazing for flipping in the super heavy cover. Gets down in there, has just ridiculous action. No idea what it imitates because it just looks really stupid in the water, but just so much action, and bass absolutely hate it to the point that they love it and eat it all the time. Now we've got the Chompers 4-inch 10 RTBR green flake. I'm not sure exactly the correct name, but this is what I use as a swim jig trailer. It's got amazing action in the water. Them two little legs just kick like this the whole entire time you're reeling them in. It's good. Chatterbait trail or swim jig trail or whatever you want. Small salty spider parts. Just like a little jig finesse presentation. I caught a bass on it in February last year, so it's really good in cold water. Good old bass munitions. Made a breacher bait. Caught my PB on one of these things. Absolutely sick action. One of my favorite creature baits. The Yum Bad Mama. And then this is a top water like frog imitation thing, and I wasn't sure where to put it, whether it be a swim bait or this, so I just do it with the creature baits. It is the Lake Lunkers custom baits, the white, like a black flake to it, top water frog type of deal, soft plastic. Never tried that before, so definitely try it this year. And then in here I believe I have some Christie Critters. It's in a Gary Yamamoto packaging because the original packaging broke on it, but these are the Yum Christie Critters. These things have a ridiculous amount of action in the water too, if you're looking for something that just looks absolutely ridiculous but catches fish. Yum Christie Critter is the way to go. The Gary Yamamoto Flapping Hog, another one of my favorite trailers. Amazing action in the water. Probably one of the first trailers I threw on a jig ever. And I love these baits. A little bit expensive, but you get what you pay for. Really nice baits. Now the Power Bait Crazy Leg Jigger Craw. Another one of them just crazy baits in the water, I mean by the name. And it puts off an insane amount of action. I caught a nice 4-pounder on one of these after a storm last year. Really good action in the water. Good jig trailer, Texas rig, whatever you want to do with it, we'll get the job done. Now these we got in the January Lucky Tackle Box, I believe. It's the Riot Baits. I'm not sure the exact name for it, but it's a little creature style bait. It kind of looks like a craw almost. I mean, all these look like craws. And then it has the little skirt material on the top. It's built into the soft plastic, so if you Texas rig it, it's basically like a jig made out of the bait. So it's a pretty neat bait. And we'll finish it up with the Strike King Rodent, which is another great flipping and pitching bait, good for punching through stuff, all around good bait. Now we'll get into all my finesse worms. Alright, as you can see, I don't do a lot of finesse worm fishing. I probably should do some more. I'd probably catch some more fish, so this year I'm going to try to do it a little bit more, get a little bit better at it. But anyway, this is my collection, I guess, I have for now. Start out with the KVD Perfect Plastics. I believe it's called like the Ocho or something. Just a really good finesse worm. If I'm not mistaken, the world record spotted bass was caught on these not too long ago. Just amazing action, nice little bait, good subtle presentation for finesse applications. Then you get the Z-Man Hoogla Sticks, which absolutely love Z-Man products because they get that stretch in them to where they won't break. They just stretch out and will not break. And just a great finesse presentation, very tough, holds up the bites pretty well. It's a nice small presentation. Then you got the Cabin Creek Buoy Worm, which is pretty much about the same length as the KVD Perfect Plastic Ocho. It's another good finesse worm. Then you got the Atrix, I hope I'm saying that right, 6-inch finesse worm. Got these in a Lucky Tackle Box long, long time ago. Used them a couple times. I've caught a couple fish on them. Nice action and pretty unique scent to them. And then you got the Mizmo Company, little finesse style blue worm. So whenever the water's muddy, dirty, whatever you want to call it, chocolate milk, go these darker colors for finesse applications. And we'll finish it up with the one of the weirdest looking worms I own. Got in a Lucky Tackle Box not too long ago. It's the Big Bite Baits 4.5-inch squirrel tail worm. This thing just has a really, really neat design to it. I'm not sure what it's going to look like in the water. I haven't thrown it yet, but definitely a finesse application worm for me, at least, how I'll be fishing it. And now we'll get into the lovely Senkos. And now the fail-safe bait that seems to catch fish no matter what. It's pretty much the easiest bait in bass fishing to fish, at least in my opinion. Caught a ton of fish on it last year, and that is the good old Senko. Let's get right into it. So we'll start it off with the Biwa Prism 4.8-inch. It's a little stick worm. I'd use it as a Senko, though, because it's pretty much got a body shape of a Senko, nothing crazy to it. Seen the action of these on an LTB video, because we got them from LTB, and really good action in the water. Plus, it's a neat darker color with some blue flakes, so definitely give this a try if the water's a little bit darker. And now the Bass Pro Shops Tournament Series, Sticko Worms. These work, honestly, almost just as well as the Gary Yamamoto's do. I think they hold up a little bit better. Gary Yamamoto has a little bit better action, but these hold up longer, and it's a lot cheaper, but we picked up a bunch of these when we were down in Florida. I think I had 3 packs. I just condensed it into 2. Now the Yum Dingers. These particular don't work well if you wacky rig them, but if you Texas rig them and put a little weight above them or rig them weightless Texas rig, they work pretty well. So we've got the Yum Dingers here. And now we'll get into something that's really new to us. We got it at ICAST. One of the companies gave it to us, called Smart Baits. These actually change color based on the water temperature. So whenever the water's warmer, they'll be a certain color. Whenever it's cooler, they'll be a different color. Apparently, it's the match to hatch, and I don't know. I haven't got a chance to throw it yet, but we'll see if it holds up to their claims that it helps out with catching a bunch of fish. So definitely going to give this a try. Excited to see how it works. And lastly, we'll finish up with 2 packs of Gary Yamamoto Senkos. The good old fail-safe original Senkos that just absolutely murder fish. So that's all the Senkos, and now get into the really quick view of my big worms. I only got 3 packs, so that won't take very long. All right, well, here's all my big worms. Not much of a collection because I don't throw a lot of big worms here in PA, but I'm definitely going to start doing it because Vinny caught a lot of fish on these 7.75-inch Gary Yamamoto cut-tail worms, and I was actually shocked. So I might start trying to throw these and maybe even go a little bit bigger, but for my collection, if you want to call it that, I have 2 packs of these Gary Yamamoto cut-tail worms, although I only have 1 left in this pack, and then I have the Bass Pro Shops Mag Finicky Worm. That's a 6-inch worm, I believe. Actually, probably more than that. No, it's 6-inch worm. So that's all my big worms, and now we'll get into flukes and swim baits, 2 of my favorite things to throw. My opinion, one of the most fun ways to fish is with either a fluke presentation or using paddle-tail swim bait. So I'm really excited to get into these. I really love this type of fishing, so we'll start out with all the flukes that I have. I have the Bass Assassin flukes, and I think it's like a baby bass color, something like that. And then I have the Zoom flukes, and another baby bass color. Another pack of Zoom flukes. This is more of a lighter color. And then I have 3 packs of these Castaic fluke style baits, if I can hold all of them up. These are all in like a white with a little bit of black, with a black top, yep. Now we'll get into the paddle tails that I have. I have 2 packs of these D&M swim baits. What makes these really neat is that the tail on these is actually flipped upside down from what a normal paddle tail swim bait looks like. And the reasoning behind that is believe it helps it stay down instead of rising up, if I believe that's what Travis was saying. So, pretty neat bait. Has some great action through it once already. And we tried to go to a pond that was actually open in PA. And now, here are two of the best paddle tail swim baits money can buy, in my opinion. The Kytec Fat Impact Swing, or Fat Swing Impact, whatever you call it. These Kyteks in the water are absolutely amazing. The swimming action on them is so realistic. You can crawl it and it'll swim. You can burn it back, it'll swim like it's a wake bait on the surface. It just, you can do so many things with these baits. They're absolutely amazing. I wouldn't recommend any other one if you want to get the best paddle tail swim bait on the market. And now, Lucky Tackle Box just gave us these. I'm actually really excited to try them. They're called the Biwa Tail Gunner Tactical Turbulence. Have a really neat design to them, good paddle tail on it. I really like the color. It's got a little bit of like a purple flash in it with like a clear color, more translucent. But these things look like they're going to have some great action in the water too. So I'm definitely excited to try these out and let you guys know how they do for me. Well, that's it for all the soft plastics. So now we've got to get into my seven different Plano boxes, which shouldn't be too bad. Okay, well, here's all the Planos. Might as well start on the top with my good old crankbait box. Okay, so let's open it up and see what we got in here. Now, I'll admit firsthand I'm not the biggest crankbait fisherman in the world, but I'm starting to get a decent little collection going. Now, I organize these crankbaits by what type of crankbait they are, how deep they dive, and color scheme on them. So we'll start with the top, and my first row has two red lipless crankbaits. One's actually a rattle trap, this one right here. Throw these back, and then I got a purple lipless crankbait, two blue lipless crankbaits, if they want to pull out, yep. And then this one, I don't know what color it is, but I caught a bunch of bass on it this summer. It's a great color. It's like a really flashy bluish with a little bit of yellow in it, green, I don't know. Tons of colors in it, puts off a lot of good vibration and flash in the water. And then these ones are all my green, or not green, yeah, kind of green, I guess. White, green, yellow, all them colors. That's what all these ones are in the top right corner. So that's all these lipless crankbaits. Put them back in here if I can. Okay, now we'll just work our way over from here. These are two pretty bright yellowish colors, so this would be good for more of a stained water. I'm not even going to worry about getting them apart. They do not come apart. Okay, there we go. These are better for stained water, a little bit shallow diving. They're both square built, so they're not going to be diving down super deep like the deep divers that we have. Throw them back. And now this crankbait's actually really neat. This is the Boyd Duckett soft body one. This crankbait, obviously by what I just said, has a soft body to it, so it's basically like a frog, like a hollow body frog, but it's crankbait. Square bill doesn't dive very deep. It's got that nice yellow color to it, so definitely give this a try. I really want to catch a bass on it just to see how it works. Then I got these two small crankbaits. One's a Live Target, one's a Rick Klund. They're both little square bills. Don't dive very deep. They're not very big, but both got some really nice color schemes on it, especially the Live Target one's got that nice crappy color to it. And then here's a little baby bass imitation square bill that I got. Pretty sure from Lucky Tackle Box. A lot of my crankbaits are from that because I'm not a really big crankbait fisherman. And here's a KVD 2.5, I believe. Nice square bill. Good color. Bill's a little bit banged up from banging off rocks and stuff, but definitely a good crankbait. It's got some good swimming action to it. And now, the latest crankbait to my collection, which is a Live Target bait ball. Dives to about, I believe, like 20 feet. So this thing will be amazing in the summer whenever the bass are out deep and the bait fish are all schooled up, because it doesn't get any better than this, guys. Sweet crankbait right here. Then here's a Rapala. I think it's called a deep diver. It only dives to like 17 feet, though. Or 13 to 14 feet. I'm actually wrong. So not too deep, but pretty nice color to it. And then these we got in a Lucky Tackle Box recently, too. I'm not sure the exact brand on it, but these dive to like 22 feet or something like that. Something crazy. They dive really deep. We got two of these in here. Pretty cool color on it, too. Something different I haven't seen a lot of. And then we'll get down to here to the Scatter Wrap, Rapala Scatter Wrap. This is like the Wiggle Ward or something. Came in the last Lucky Tackle Box, one of the throwback lures baits. This is another Rapala, I believe. Nice little black color with the black dot. And then lastly, finished up with another scatter wrap. This was a different body design, a little bit longer and skinnier. And that's it for my crankbait box. Now we're going to hop into my jerkbait box. Here's my jerkbait box, again organized by color and size and all them great things. So can't really elaborate too much on jerkbaits. I don't jerkbait fish a lot, but I have caught a lot of fish on a jerkbait. I just don't do it a lot. Anyways, got these monster bass, like slim something like that. It's called like the Slim Jim, I don't know, something like that. Monster bass lures, kind of looks like a mega bass to be honest, but I don't care. It has great action in the water. I've messed around with it a little bit already. Great jerkbait. I got two of these, one there and one here. Got these nice purple colored ones, the Challenger. And then for some reason I have spy baits in here too. I got a spy bait right here and a spy bait right here. Got this. This one I actually caught a nice pike on. This came from an LTB. I'm not sure the exact brand on it, but it got beat up pretty bad. Hooks broke off, so I had to replace the hooks on it. Another nice jerkbait. A lot of jerkbaits here, guys. And then got a Rapala. I believe this is called a Husky Jerk, I believe. Yeah, Rapala Husky Jerk, I think. And got a little bit deeper diving jerkbait. And then these ones right here, here, and then over here. These are all generic brands that aren't very expensive. Now, the reason I have these is for whenever we go up the Shenango Dam, you can lose a lot of lures there really fast. So I like to throw these more generic ones. They still get the job done. I just replace out the hooks and put on some good quality hooks so I don't lose any fish. But that's the reason why I buy those. And that's the jerkbait box. And now we'll get into good old topwater. All right, so this is my topwater box. As you can see, it's pretty full. And across the top, I have all my frog imitations. So I got my good old hula popper. Then I got the Spro popping frogs. I got all that stuff in the top. Then you go over one more, and I have my Lunker Hunt stuff. So I got two of these in that one, the Lunker Hunt Poppin' Frog, pretty good frog. Alright, then you go one more over, and I got another whole entire row full of Lunker Hunt Poppin' Frogs. This is the smaller one, it's like a quarter ounce. And this is one that doesn't have the same head design in the front, it's not that poppin' design like this one. So that's all my Lunker Hunt frogs, and now I have good old-fashioned live target hollow body. This catches a ton of fish. Down in Florida, this did pretty good for us. Now we were down there for iCast. Got some more hula poppers in here. Got a bunch of those. Do pretty good on these, more in creeks for like smallmouth and stuff, other than largemouth. Over here, we got the jitterbugs, which the very first topwater bait I ever threw and the very first fish I ever caught on topwater was on a jitterbug, so I got all these. Fun bait, really good action, pretty easy to work. It's good to get someone started on if you want to. And here I got some Rapala spook looking baits with a little blade on the back and some more Zara spooks. These are two poppers from a Japanese company that we got in LTB. This is a live target popping frog type of deal. Rapala popper right here. Another little Zedden spook bait type of thing with the blades on it. Another one of those. And then here's a Yozuri popper, which is pretty cool. I think it's another Yozuri popper right here. No, that's a Livingston. This is a Livingston lures popper. So this one emits the bait sounds as it goes. And then right here we've got two more Livingston lures. Two walking style baits. They both actually light up in the water and give off sounds. So pretty neat looking baits. That's my top water box for you guys. And now we'll get into my swim bait box. Alright, and here's my swim bait box, which is starting to grow a little bit. It'll be growing a lot more once my tackle warehouse order gets here. With my Huddleston and Mag Draft and all that wonderful stuff. Start out with the giant swim baits I have in the top, which are the Livingston Venom or Viper or something like that. These are 6 inches, pretty big glide bait. Got two of those. I got another one over here in the blue color. And over here, I believe this is a Boyd Duckett swim bait. It's got a nice bill on it, so it's going to dive down a little bit. Multiple joints, so it's got pretty good swimming action. This is another Boyd Duckett one, I believe. This is, again, multiple joints, so it's going to have a pretty good swimming action on it. I believe it's got the magnet here. Yep, keep the hook out. The Live Target swim bait, which you guys already know by seeing that Live Target video, that we're a pretty big fan of these. This is a smaller one. I want to get a bigger one, but don't have the money to right now.
This is a castaic line through swim bait. So you feed the line through the head and it pops out down here, tied into the hook, and the hook's magnetic here. This is a Biwa trout swim bait. This one's sick. It has a ton of action in the water. Super realistic. Looks just like a trout. This is another Biwa swim bait. A little bit of a gold color to it. Flashy. A lot of joints. So it's got nice wide swimming action. And then here we just got some more paddle tails that are just miscellaneous, like yum and some power bait things down there. Then here's some swim baits that have the steel leader connected to them, so whenever a fish bites, it pulls out. And then we also got the replaceable tails for them. I got two of these, so one there and one here. And that's my swim bait box. Not too impressive yet, but once my order comes in with my Huddleston and my mag draft and my S waiver, all that wonderful stuff, swim bait collection will keep on growing. Okay, now the good old jig box. Just had that jig video come out, so let's see what I got in here. Oh my, I need to actually stock up on some jigs. So the top row, start out with this gravity, zero gravity jig, which is super light, falls really slow, really finesse type of jig. Then I got this orange color, just normal jig, probably like 3/8 or a little bit even lighter than that, pretty light jig. Got this one in like a green pumpkin with a little bit of like a red flake in it. And this one I believe is 3/4 ounce, and it's pretty big. So this is a bigger jig. Get down there deeper, faster. So this will be for my bigger baits, hopefully catch some bigger fish on it. And then I just got a white jig right here, which I really haven't used much, but better have it for bed fishing and that kind of stuff. And then here I got all these like yum, I think they're just called yum crawdads or something like that. Just have them rigged up on some jig heads. Just simple for smallmouth fishing, or even largemouth will work for either. Down here I got some fluorescent stand-up jigs and then just some regular fluorescent jigs. I got this wobble head thing or something like that from Lucky Tackle Box. You put it on top of your hook, like you attach your hook to it, and then whenever you're bringing in your bait, this is going to dig into the bottom, and it's basically like a jig head that's going to cause a lot of commotion and bring the bass in. And then lastly I got a good old swim jig with that Chompers trailer I was telling you about earlier. You can see right here them legs just go like crazy, so really good bait. And that's it for the jig box. Now one of the most important boxes in my opinion, which is the terminal tackle box. Sorry, it's so loud. Okay, so I organized this by hook type and hook size and all that stuff, so we'll start up here. These are my, I believe, 2-aught EWG hooks up here, 3-aught EWG hooks, 4-aught EWG hooks, let's say that. Then over here I got my 2-aught worm hooks, 3-aught worm hooks, and then I'll get 4-aught worm hooks here eventually. These are the wireless hooks with that little snare thing. Hopefully you guys can see that. Keeps them wireless, weedless. These are my hooks that I use for wacky rigging and drop shotting. Like this one's that zero twist shot from Mustab. Nice hooks there. And these are my swim bait hooks. This is in 4-aught size, so this will be for like 5-inch swim baits. Pretty big swim baits I'm going to put on this one. And this one is in 3-aught size. It's also lighter than that one. Then these are just my normal weighted hooks here. Don't really use them a lot, but nice to have them. Replacement trebles in red. And then just normal color, a little bit bigger. And then over here, just normal color again. And then I got my bobber stoppers. I got a big pack of them over here for whenever I'm Texas rigging, I need to stop things. Got my O-rings for the wacky tool. A little tape measure over here. One drop shot weight. You can tell I don't drop shot very much. Bunch of split shots and swivels just to like modify some stuff. And then all of my weights go from lightest to heaviest. So these are, I believe, like 1/8 or something like that. And then these are 1/4. And these are 1/2 ounce. So these are the biggest ones out of all of them. That's my terminal tackle box. And now I've only got one more left. And all right, now we're just going to finish up with this miscellaneous box. This has my chatterbaits, which I only got one in here right now. I need to stock up on those. The Lunker Hunt hatch spins, which is just pretty heavy lure with a nice underspin underneath it. Good action in the water. Get down there deep. Got this gold spoon, and then I've got these two, I believe they're both blue. Yeah, these two blue and silver spoons. And then the wacky tool for wacky rigging. Good old trusty Leatherman.
for whatever you need it on the water for. You can never go without one. And that is all of my tackle, guys. All
right, now for the giveaway part of this video. Hopefully you guys stuck around and watched the whole video. Sorry it was kind of long, but got a lot of tackle for not even being a tournament angler. Got a pretty good amount of tackle, so since I have so much tackle, I want to give back to you guys that are watching this if we hit the 50 likes, which I think we will. I think you guys got this. Anyways, what I'm going to be giving away is one pack of these Riot baits that are pretty neat. Creature baits with the skirt built into them. Pretty neat looking bait. The V&M little paddle tail swim bait things with the upside down tail for the extra action so it dives down. Really neat bait. Got some good action. I've already used it in the water. And lastly, I'll be giving away one of the Castaic Baits fluke packages. These things are pretty good flukes. If you're just getting into fluke fishing, it's really fun. You really get to watch the fish hit you the water, so it doesn't get any better than that. So, if you want a chance to win all three of these, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, comment down below anything regarding the video, future video ideas, your favorite tackle, whatever you want, comment it down below for a chance to be entered into this. Let's reach 50 likes, guys. I think we got this. As always, thanks for watching, and stay hooked.